First off, you've said that the Senate probe into the alleged disappearance of minors recruited by leftist organizations is meant to harass administration critics. Why do you think that?
Well, because first of all, now that we are carefully looking into the matter, especially in light of the latest news that those youth involved have already spoken on the issue, which renders much of the Fed resolution's provisions devoid of any semblance of truth. So we think that as a base, you know, from the recent pronouncement surrounding the hearing, we find the calls for increased police presence and the moves to amend existing agreements in schools with regard to militarization to curtail our rights, especially disconcerting.
All right. Do you think this probe is targeting certain or specific organizations, school organizations at that?
Well, the resolution mentioned a broad terms on leftist groups. So It's not a crime to organize and to form leftist groups, though it is a crime to recruit minors and children in armed groups based on the newly enacted law on children in situations of armed conflict. So we find it really malicious and slanderous that the hearing is relating or connecting these leftist groups, these legitimate organized groups, to a recruitment of minors.
All right, given that kind of situation, how do you think this will develop as an attack on the youth and schools, as you're saying?
Well, as a youth sectoral party list, we are committed to giving voice to the marginalized and underrepresented. So we'll still continue to engage by initiating a school and community programs and projects, know the conditions of our constituents, and speak up whenever the voice of the youth is needed.
All right. You said that Senator Ronald De La Rosa, a former police chief, supposedly attempted during the hearing to link or junk an agreement for law enforcers to get permission from school authorities before entering the premises, the campus, perhaps. Can you explain?
Yes, because such measures will surely result in the repression and stifling of dissent, specifically targeting the students, teachers, and school officials who have been at the forefront of organizing debates and discussions discussing the Duterte administration's programs, such as the drug war, discussing relevant issues on attacks and killings of human rights defenders, even economic issues such as tax hikes and proposed amendments to the Philippine Charter.
Yes, lastly, how would you counsel schools? This is a precarious time. There has to be some changes in the way they conduct themselves, tackling all of these issues. How would you counsel schools and youth groups?
This really presents the urgent need to unite as Filipino youth and as Filipino people for us to assert our democratic rights, not only inside the premises of our campuses, but to assert our fundamental freedoms in pursuit of truth and holding power to account for building a truly democratic society. So on the part of Kabataan, I will continue to struggle for a higher education space that is critical and discerning of all the information we read and share. So I will have dialogues. We'll continue to organize dialogues, especially we strongly encourage those parents po na nagsalita din sa hearing to talk to their children. No? We can support them by organizing a setting or a place where the parent, both the parent and their children, can feel free to exchange their messages po, to each other.